Welcome back. The Cheryl Special is available on the internet, but not at your local diner. It's a scathing reference to Hillary Clinton's State Department Chief of Staff, Cheryl Mills, written by Clinton ally and Democratic activist Neera Tanden. We know about this because of WikiLeaks. At issue, that moment when those outside of Clinton's innermost circle found out about that private email server at her home. Quote, "Why didn't they get stuff like this out 18 months ago? So crazy," Ms. Tanden wrote in an email to Clinton campaign chairman John Podesta. His reply? Unbelievable. Tanden's response? "I guess I know the answer. They wanted to get away with it." Ouch. Republicans are seizing on these. Again, these are documents released from John Podesta's email by WikiLeaks. The Clinton campaign says they won't talk about the specifics because the Russian government allegedly hacked them and gave them to WikiLeaks. But this shows you the angst. Even her campaign chairman wasn't told until very late that she had a private email server in her Chappaqua, New York home when she was Secretary of State. And it shows you the secrecy, some would say paranoia, of Hillary Clinton and her inner circle. When I covered the Clinton White House, Cheryl Mills was part of the impeachment team. She was a lawyer on part of the impeachment team. It's the, we can keep this from people until the last possible second and only release it if we're forced to release it. What does that tell us about what a Hillary Clinton presidency would be?
I mean, that's the big issue. I mean, will you have the same kind of problems in this presidency? Should she get elected to the Oval Office? I mean, terrible that her inner circle is talking about this in this way. It would be more terrible, I think, for them if it had come earlier, because it shows sort of infighting and upset with Hillary Clinton. Some of the things that we saw in that 2008 campaign, different circles of power. I think one of the things about this, it's certainly new information about an old problem. And an old issue that probably for most voters is baked into the cake. If you look at 2012, about 20% of voters made up their minds about who to vote for in October, and they basically split 50 for Obama, 46 for Mitt Romney. So thankfully for Hillary Clinton, some of this probably is baked into the cake, but it does foreshadow some of these same problems.
These are people who love her. Yeah. These are not critics. These are people who love her and support her, saying she's nuts and she's secretive and she's...
Well,